back for a new video. In today's fashion breakdown, we're talking about a fashionista that I have been a fan of for a very long time, and that is Oliver Sykes. As many of you already know, he is the frontman of Bring Me the Horizon and also the owner of Drop Dead Clothing. Drop Dead is an all-around dope alternative fashion brand that he founded back in 2005. They feature both men's and women's apparel, and they release new limited edition collections every single season, oftentimes with really cool themes such as Itchy and Scratchy, Gremlins, or Jurassic Park. Throughout the years, I've purchased lots of items from Drop Dead for myself and been very happy with all of them. I can definitely say that I would consider Drop Dead to be one of the most influential and well-known alternative fashion brands. Now, with that little bit covered, let's move on to talking about some music videos. I wanted to start as far back as possible with the video for Pray for Plagues in 2007. However, you can't really see him at all that well in that music video. It's like 240p and in a 3x4 aspect ratio, and for half of it, he's kind of just topless anyways. So I moved on from there to Chelsea Smile, Diamonds Aren't Forever, The Sadness Will Never End, and It Never Ends. And instead of talking about each one of those four videos individually, I'm kind of amalgamating them all together. And the reason for that is because he's dressed very similarly in all of them. He's essentially wearing a different variation of skinny jeans with either a muscle tank, t-shirt, or sweater. None of that is bad by any means, and in fact, it's probably what I would wear if I was a guy. However, it's not that unique or really worth taking time to focus on individually. So once you move on from those five music videos very early on in Bring Me the Horizon's career, you get to the video for Alligator Blood in 2011. This is the first music video where he is not wearing a sort of variation of skinny jeans and t-shirts. And in fact, in this video, the whole entire band is dressed formally. They're all wearing dress shirts. Ollie himself has on a dress shirt, not buttoned up all the way, paired with a black blazer over top. Both of those upper garments fit him really nicely. They don't seem too tight. The cuffs stick out just the right amount at the wrist. And I can't get a good look at his pants, but I think that those are fitting all right as well. Now, moving on to Shadow Moses in 2013. This is just like a little bit of a pit stop because this outfit isn't that amazing. It's not that great. But it's a nice sweater with some cute little elbow patch detailing, and all in all, he looks nice. Next up is the video for Sleepwalking, also from 2013. Here again isn't like the best outfit ever, but it's a pretty solid combo. I like how his t-shirt, I believe it's like merch for the band Death, could be wrong, let me know in the comments. It's got sort of like red and purple on the front, and then over top of that, he's wearing a plaid shirt, but the plaid shirt is sort of like an orange or like a dark yellow ochre color, and I really like the contrast going on between those two items. In 2014, we are back to formal again with the music video for Drown. He actually looks very sharp in this music video. I would say that his shirt and jacket up top fit super nicely, as well as the pants. The pants, the rise is great for him. It's not cutting off his torso too soon. I think that the pants are not too tight and not too loose. The only thing I would change about the pants is I think they need to be hemmed like a half an inch to an inch shorter because they're bunching just a little bit at the shoe, and I'd rather it literally just hit the shoe, break like a tiny bit, and then that's it. All in all though, he looks great in this music video. Moving forward to 2015, we have one more amalgamation, and I'm gonna talk here about both Throne and True Friends at once. In both videos, he's wearing skinny jeans. In Throne, he has on a muscle tank cut very dramatically, very deeply around the sides, and it looks actually really good on him. And then in True Friends, he's wearing skinny jeans again, but this time with a sweater that is like very distressed, and he has it rolled up a couple times on each wrist. Again, these are outfits that I would wear, that I would dress Wyatt in, but they're not like super revolutionary. For 2016, I want to talk about the music video for Oh No. In this video, he's wearing a very, very cool paisley or almost paisley printed button-down shirt, and like now we are starting to get a little warmer, a little bit more spicy, you could say. The shirt fits him super well, isn't like the most expected item for a metal frontman to wear, I don't think. And all in all, it's just kind of cool. It's got that cool factor. All right, 2018, we are moving on to the music video for Mantra, a super dope music video. The very first scenes in which you see Ollie in this music video, he is looking like a wreck. He's wearing some sort of weird fleece house coat thing. He's meant to be looking really sort of worn out and ratty and just lost and dingy, and totally works. However, then we move on to two amazing outfits. The first one you only see for a couple of glimpses, a couple of scenes in this whole music video, but it's him wearing an entirely white suit. Like I said, I can't get a super good look at it, but from what I can see in these few glimpses, it looks like it fits him great and is very sharp against the band, who are all wearing black. Then the second and more featured outfit in this music video is this red outfit. And this is amazing! This is one of the first times I got super excited while watching these music videos. What he's wearing is, first of all, every gold chain in the entire world around his neck, and then a red button-down shirt that has no collar, so it's sort of almost like a Mandarin collar, but it's really just picture like a dress shirt with no collar, but the stand is still there and it's really thin and narrow. And then over top of that, he's wearing a red sort of robe, or like, I don't even know what the word is for it. It's kind of a robe. It's kind of just like, yeah, it's a robe. It's basically a robe. And then of course, matching red pants and some sandals. I know the point of this is that he's meant to be a cult leader, and it totally works. Like, he totally suits his role, and I think it's such a good outfit. Like, even outside of the theme of the video, if he just wore that, I would be all in. Next up in 2019 is the music video for Sugar Honey, Ice and Tea. The very opening scene outfit in this music video is absolutely insane. He's wearing shorts and a long sleeve shirt that it almost kind of looks like a scuba style outfit, because it looks like it's really sort of thin, athletic, like spandex or nylon material that's really stretchy, with just like this crazy overall print like all over it. He's of course standing in front of a green screen and has on these tall black crew socks, which is like kind of funny. And then in other shots in the same music video, you see him wearing this outfit, except this time the shirt goes all the way up over his hands and into gloves, so that it's almost like one full thing on each arm of this crazy printed getup. And it's just really cool and different. Then later on in the music video, there's a couple scenes where you see him sort of sitting on the floor, and he's wearing a pink t-shirt with wide-legged black pants and dirty white running shoes. And sometimes I just can't describe why, but things are good. And just this right now is a look. Next up is Ludens from 2019, and buckle in, everybody. He looks straight up amazing, perfect, killer in this video. Ollie is a man with many, many cool jackets, and this is the first one in this video that we're gonna be discussing. And this jacket is so cool to me because it's almost like it's meant to be a deconstructed suit jacket. I saw that it was made for him by the head designer at Drop Dead, of course, which is super cool. And the way it looks is literally just like someone took a suit jacket and like cut it off at the bottom because it's cropped really short and sort of frayed. And then it has all these different patches all over it. It has the band's logo spray painted or painted or somehow applied to the back. And then on one arm of the jacket, it's sort of ripped up and like slashed and frayed, almost like it's revealing sort of like the lining underneath or some sort of additional fabric that was put onto just that one arm. Something about this jacket and about all of his jackets really that I really admire for whoever made it for him is that every last square inch of the surface of this jacket has been thought about and accounted for. Sleeves are not the place where people normally put anything. Like, sleeves are just kind of there. Like, you don't normally think like, oh, I'm gonna put patches on my sleeves. You think I'm gonna put patches on my back or like the breast area, sort of like the torso area. But for many of his jackets, there's a lot of really cool, really like unique detailing going on the sleeves. And I really appreciate that. Now, moving away from the jacket, of course, this outfit is paired with pants that 10 out of 10 pants, they fit him beautifully. Then of course he has the perfect accessories to go with these two pieces. He's got the shiny shoes, a belt, earring. Like, I noticed that in the last couple years, he's always seen wearing like one dangly earring, and it is such a look. And I'm so here for that. Guys, if you have your ears pierced, like, don't forget about earrings. They're so cool. So yeah, this outfit, ever since the first moment I saw it, has stuck with me. Just a killer outfit. Next up, last music video we're gonna discuss for the day is Obey. This leather jacket that he's wearing with the flames on it is so fun, and I love how it's paired with this dress shirt underneath. The dress shirt is white with black contrast stitching on top, something that just looking at makes me nervous. When I was in fashion school, one of the first couple projects we did were to sew a dress shirt and a skirt, all of which were made out of muslin, which has this very, very light, creamy color, and you always, always, always had to sew on it in black so that the instructors could see every last little bit of stitching and verify that it is straight and correct and neat. And so now every time I see this contrast stitching, it just reminds me of those projects. But anyways, it looks great. And of course, those two top garments are paired with some nice stripy trousers on the bottom, which I really like as well. Now, that is the end of the music videos, but there's way more outfits to talk about. I've collected some notable looks from around the internet, some interviews, some live performances, just different outfits that I've found that I have really, really liked. The first one is this interview that Bring Me the Horizon did for the Brit Awards in February of 2020. He just looks so effortlessly chic. Once again, a man of many jackets, this jacket is amazing. I can't tell exactly what's on it, but it's essentially like a regular formal blazer. And the two front panels, and probably the back as well, have a really like oversized large scale print on them. And then underneath, he's paired it with a t-shirt that also has a print on it in a different color, but it's very understated. It's almost just like the little bit around the collar in the center front has been like bleached or almost like a little bit tie-dyed. I can't see his pants, but I would say that these top garments paired with his like rose pink hair and once again a dangly earring, it all looks great. Next up is a video that Ollie did for the YouTube channel Genius in 2019 where he's breaking down the lyrics for Mothertown. In it, he's wearing, of course, again, another amazing jacket. This one is black denim and is covered with a bunch of patches as usual, all of which have been safety pinned down. I love how on his right side, there's a bunch of patches that are all the same, all just sort of jumbled up on top of each other. I think that's a really cool effect. And then of course on his left arm, like I said, every little bit of real estate of these jackets has been accounted for. He has a really big patch that's almost like a portrait of something on his left arm. So that's really neat. And then of course there's just general distressing all over the jacket where it's like fraying and coming apart at a couple spots, you know, around the collar and the pocket flaps on the breast, just a little bit everywhere, right? All right, you guys, last up. We have an outfit that he wore in 2019 for Lollapalooza in Chile. This, I would say, is my absolute number one favorite outfit. And let's break it down piece by piece. First up, of course, he has on another amazing jacket. This one is sort of more a bomber jacket base because it's got the elasticized waist. It's got just a straight up zipper along the center front and more of a shirt collar. And then, of course, it's distressed in the most beautiful way and covered with interesting patches and painting and almost like graffiti looking stuff. Every last square inch of this jacket was accounted for. Moving on underneath the jacket, which he actually ends up taking off like a quarter of the way through this video anyways, he's wearing a button-down shirt that at first glance looks to be floral. Not so fast, my friends. That is not a floral shirt. That is the character Him from Powerpuff Girls. Yes. That is right. I paused the video, I looked at the shirt, and I said, that can't be it. But that's it. That is it. That is the character Him from Powerpuff Girls. I don't know how or where or why he acquired this shirt. I tried to look it up. I couldn't find it. Perhaps he had it custom made for himself. I don't know. But either way, it's so fun and unique and different. And it looks good underneath that jacket. Then of course he has on this denim, which is not his usual denim that he's been seen in over the years. These jeans have no distressing, no fading, no whiskering. They're just purely deep, deep indigo, fresh, clean looking jeans. They have white contrast stitching on them and they fit him nicely. They're not skinny jeans. There's just more of like a straight leg, slim fitted jean with cuffs at the bottom so as to reveal his socks and boots. He has, of course, his Him shirt French tucked into the pants, which I love a French tuck. Basically, all it means is taking the front only of your shirt and tucking into the front of your pants. And then his boots, of course, he's got on one black and one white boot, which is just so fun and different. All in all, this is such an amazing outfit to me. I feel like it covers all of the bases, and I feel like it really represents who he is nowadays. Like I said at the beginning, he never dressed badly. He wore what was expected. He wore what somebody who was the front man of a metal band in 2010 through 2014 would wear. And you know, it looked good on him. It fit him well, he looked fine. However, in the last couple of years, he's really pushed his boundaries and he's really just sort of done like a 180 with his personal style and just gone from wearing what was expected to what is completely unexpected. He shows so much more personality through his style now. You can just tell that he's really evolved as a person through both his music, through his brand Drop Dead, and through how he dresses himself. All in all, I must say, I've been a fan of him for years since the Suicide Season days, and I can say he looks his best now. And I would consider him to be the most fashionable person in metal. So that's where I'm gonna end today's video. I hope that you enjoyed this fashion breakdown of Ollie Sykes. If you did, please let me know in the comments below. Also, let me know who else you would like to see on a fashion breakdown video in the future. I have a couple people in mind and I've seen you guys been requesting them, but I also would like some new ideas too. Please, if you haven't yet, check out my own brand. It's called Lynn Devil. The links are in the description below. Thank you so much for watching this video and I'll see you in the next one.